Hi everyone, I'm Ed Liss, jukebox collector, music historian. Welcome to another session of Jukebox Bios. Today we're going to feature this beautiful Art Deco jukebox, this 1940 Wurlitzer Model 800, the first deluxe jukebox in the industry. The Wurlitzer Model 800 was manufactured at the North Tonawanda, New York factory in 1940. It was the first jukebox to be designated as a deluxe model and the first to use the bubble tube design provided by BioLite Corporation of New York. Housing a massive cabinet, its design was considered streamlined at the time due to its swept-back appearance that gave it a look of being in motion. The side pilasters were made of Catalan plastic and were injection molded to enable swirls to be embedded inside for visual effect. The pilasters rotated inward towards the center of the jukebox to provide a changing glow of colors on the grill. Three bubble tubes in the center of the grill provided a constant stream of light and color as the liquid circulated in the sealed tube. The liquid used was methylene bichloride, which was basically paint stripper that had a boiling point of 30 degrees centigrade. The tube sat in a ceramic heater, which when electrified, released the liquid into the sealed chamber and recirculated. The rotating color cylinders were offset by the Catalan plastics to create a look of live fire. The cabinet was made of a high-quality walnut veneer. The grill housed a series of red discs that adorned the entire front to provide a brilliant overall glow that gave the machine a beautiful presence. The Model 800 used the Simplex 24 Selection 78 RPM mechanism matched to an 18-watt tube amplifier and a 15-inch Motorola dynamic range speaker. All selections were made first before a coin was inserted using a 24-key selector unit under the front glass. One of the drawbacks of the system was that once a key was depressed, it could be changed by simply releasing it and selecting another, prompting a few fist fights among disgruntled patrons. The Model 800 had superb fidelity with smooth bass response, or bottom as it was called. I purchased the machine as a complete but non-working unit from a photo that was sent to me showing it sitting in a warehouse in Oklahoma City in 1982. It looked like a wreck, but all the components were intact. So I took it apart and sent the cabinet and the components to Glenn Streeter in California for a complete restoration. I dropped to my knees and cried like a baby, looking at this incredible transformation from a pile of junk into a museum piece. I've owned this machine since 1983, and I never get tired of listening to the authentic sound and superb fidelity. The machine is loaded with 24 big band 78 RPM records that precisely matches the music to the era. Designed by Paul M. Fuller, the Picasso of jukebox design from this period, the Wurlitzer 800 is truly one of the great collectible jukeboxes that represents the golden era of jukeboxes in American culture at that time. It is a timeless and classic masterpiece, a work of art worthy of display in any museum in the world.